And finally, if we're going to be radical for Christ, it means that you're tough. Hear me now. Hear me. It means that you're tough against sin in your own life.
Come on.
I said your own life.
Come on.
Now, what I found in the church is we're tough against sin when it's in somebody else's life.
Come on now.
But not our own life. Yeah. It's amazing how much we can point out sins and faults, idiosyncrasies in other people.
Yes.
But we can't even see them in our own lives.
Right.
Jesus said, oh, we can see the pebble in our brother's eye. Can't even see the beam in our own eye.
Amen.
And so therefore, if we're going to be radical for the Lord, we have to be tough against sin in our own life. Let me explain. When you look at the life of Zacchaeus, it is amazing what he did. Because the Bible said he gave half of his goods. Now, he was rich, he was wealthy, he had a supply, you know, a surplus, if you will. And the Bible said he gave half his goods to the poor. Now, God never required that, mind you.
Amen.
According to the law, he had to give 10%. You know, every 7 years they release debts, you know, those who are in poverty. But God never required anybody to give half of their goods to feed the poor. He did that himself.
Amen.
And he said, Lord, if I have taken anything from anyone by false accusation,
Amen.
I will restore them fourfold. All right, stop right there. Because according to the law, if you took something from someone, if you stole from them, the law required you gave it back plus 20%. In other words, I took from you $100. That means if I was caught and I was honest, I would give you back 120. Okay, that was according to the law. Zacchaeus said, no, I'll do one better. He said, Lord, I tell you what, if I ever take anything from anyone by false accusation, I'm not going to give them 20%. I give them 400%. You follow me?
Amen.
If I take 100, if I do anything that's unethical, I'll give them back $400.
Amen.
Are you following me?
Yes.
And so therefore, if we're real, I mean, he was so tough on sin. Listen, not in everybody else, but in his own life.
Yes.
And consequently, when you're radical for the Lord, you have uncommon integrity and you have ethics that are above reproach.
Yes.
I'm talking about playing church. I'm talking about when you're serious now. I'm not talking about just coming to church so people can see you. When you're serious, when this gospel, listen, when your life is actually changing, are you following me? When the gospel is making a difference and an impact in your life, listen, you will have integrity. You will have strong moral ethics when you're radical for the Lord.
Amen.
When you're zealous about
Hallelujah.
The things of God and you see it so clearly. In his life. Pastor, give me one more example. I'm so glad you asked. You know, Joseph was that same way. All right, now here I go now.
Come on.
All right, men and women. I'm not going to beat on the men today. Men
Come
and
on.
Women.
Come on.
The Bible says, Joseph, Potiphar's wife, now, here you go, made sexual advances toward him.
Come on.
Okay. Well, actually, I don't know what I'm talking about. You know, you get older, you get married, people don't all of a sudden start getting ugly. The Bible says, Potiphar's wife made sexual advances. And get this, notice what he did not do. I'm talking about someone who's radical for the Lord. Serious about his walk with God. He didn't say, girl, just stop. You playing. Leave me alone. No, he didn't do that. The Bible said he ran so fast, he left his coat.
Yes.
He said, how in the world can I do this thing and sin against God?
Amen.
You talk about radical.
Yes.
You talk about serious.
Yes.
You talk about zealous.
Yes.
For the Lord. Now,
yes.
This is a challenge, especially in this day and age,
yes.
Because in today's culture, it's hard to be tough against sin in your own life because we live in a world that has normalized sin.
Yes.
In fact, it's more easy and more common to live and practice sin as it is to practice righteousness.
Yes.
And so you really have to march to a beat of a different drum.
Yes.
You have to go against the tide. You have to push, go against the grain. There has to be somewhat of a counterculture in the body of Christ if you're going to be tough against sin. Now, the Bible says we all sin and come short of the glory of God, but some are tougher on sin in their own life than others, clearly. See? Some people, now, when you're radical for the Lord, when you do sin, now, we all miss the sin, but when you do sin, get this, it really bothers you.
Yes.
Bothers you.
Yes.
That's why God did use David so often. Wasn't a perfect man, but when he did miss in a sin, it bothered him to no end.
Yes.
That's when you're radical for the Lord.
Amen.
That's when you're radical for Christ.